We are going to be doing text classification using spacey word embeddings in this video. I have taken a news data set where the news is classified as fake or real. And this is the CSV file I have. Someone wrote a news saying top Trump surrogate brutally stabs him in the back. Clearly it's a fake news and it is classified such in this CSV file. Let's load that file into Pandas data frame. The data frame looks something like this. If you notice the shape of the file, 9,900 records in total. And I will do value counts just to figure out if there is a class imbalance or not. Looks like none. Almost similar samples we have. If these samples were very different, let's say you have fake news is 5,000 and real news is only 1,000, then you have to do something to address that class imbalance. I will now convert this label column into numbers. Obviously, machine learning models understand the numbers better than the text. So from a label column, I want to generate new column called label num, which will be a simple number. And you can use map function for this purpose where you can say if it is fake, let's say for fake, you want to keep a zero number. And for real, you want to keep it one. Okay. All right. So you get this label number column created. Now you want to convert this text column into the corresponding word vectors. Now in the previous video, we already saw spaces word vectors and we learned that we need to load a large model, right? So I'm hoping you're watching the videos in this playlist in the sequence so that you have some context. So in the last video, we loaded the large model that has word vectors. And now we want to convert this text into a word vector. And the way you do that is, let's say you have text like this, you put it in a document object, and that document object will have a vector. So this vector size is 300, okay, 300 element vector. And I want to do this for every single row, okay? So I'm thinking maybe I can create a new column in my Pandas data frame, which can store vector for that particular text. Okay. And the way to do that would be similar to what we did here, right? We created df text. Okay. And okay, from df text, you want to convert to a vector, right? So what will you do? So you will say, okay, df vector is equal to df.text dot apply. So you want to apply some function on every element in this text column. And you know, in Pandas, you can do that easily using a lambda function. So lambda x will give you each individual text, the whole news. And then that news, you can convert it to NLPC. We can convert NLP in bracket text. So this will be the text dot vector. So this should give you the vector. You can run it. Now the thing is, this is not a very fast operation. So when I do control enter, execute this, it's gonna take more than 15 minutes. So I will do that and I'll be back after a few minutes. All right, so I'm back now and you can see that the vector column is created. Each element is 300 element vector. And now we will use this particular vector to train our model. And whenever we train our model, the first thing we do is we import train test split from sklearn. We have done this so many times, so I don't need to type it and I can just copy paste. And in the train test split, you will specify your x. So your x is df.vector. Your y is label number, okay? And your test size, let's say I want only 20% sample to be in my test category. And then I like to specify random state, that way I run this multiple time, I see some predictability, okay? And you can specify, stratify, but I think it's okay. And in the result, you will get this. Okay, now when you look at X-train, let's see. Actually, if I do df.vector, that's not good because I want to get the values in it. So let me do values here. All right, so if you look at the shape, total there are 7,900 element, okay, which is fine. And X test has 1980, 80-20% split. But if you look at the actual array, it is a NumPy array, but the every single individual element is another NumPy array. When we give this to our classifier for the training, it is expecting 2D NumPy array. So we need to convert this array from this format to a 2D NumPy array. And how do you do that? Well, in NumPy, there is a function called stack. So let's say NumPy stack function. And if you look at that stack function, see, let's say you have an array. Let me see if I can find an example here. See here, each individual array is a NumPy array itself. But when you do hnp.stack, it will convert it into a native 2D NumPy array. Okay, if you don't know about NumPy, you can follow my tutorial so you'll get an idea. So here, let's see, where were we? Yes, I am going to now import NumPy. So import NumPy as np, np.stack, and I will call it maybe xtrain. As you do the same thing for xtest also. Okay, so xtest. Now check this. See, this is a proper 2D NumPy array. If you looked at our previous xtrain, it was an array and every single element in that array was another NumPy array. And that kind of structure doesn't work well with your sklearn training. Okay, now we are ready to import our sklearn classifier. So I will just import sklearn classifier. I'll use multinomial naive based model first because that's the most popular one for NLP type of problem. It tends to perform well. And then on that you can do fit. Okay, and then ytrain. Now see, this array has negative elements, so most likely I will get a problem. And the reason for the problem is that negative values are not acceptable in multinomial NB. What do you do now? So you have positive negative values in your training data set. Now you want to tackle this problem of not having negative values. So if you know about scaling, so scaling can help you convert those values into positive range. So you can do maybe a min-max scaler. I will import a min-max scaler here, okay? And then create an object of this scaler class, and this is how you do it, scaler. And then on scaler, you will do fit transform, right? Fit transform. If you have followed my machine learning videos previously, you will get an idea. And this 2D, I want it to be passed as an argument, and I will call this an scaled train embed, and I'll do the same thing for the taste embed, okay? And here you don't need to do fit transform. You can just say transform. All right, so now I will pass scaled train data set as an input into classification model. Looks like training worked and it trained it so freaking fast. Okay, now I will print a classification report. So usually whenever I train a model, you know, it's a general practice, not just me. Everyone tries to evaluate the performance on the test data set. And the way you do that is you will do clf.predict on xtest2d, and that you get it as actually not xtest2d. I'm thinking this one, yes. And that is your y prediction, okay? And then you can just in the classification report, you supply y truth and y prediction. And you use print because that way it can print it in a nice format. Look at the result, rock solid, right? More than 90% precision recall F1 score. So you see how easy is it to train a text classification model using the ready-made word embeddings that come with Spacy. We have done the similar thing by using TF-IDF and bag of n-grams and so on in our previous videos. But this was a little easier because you got the embedding ready-made out of the box. Now let me try one more classifier, which is KNN, K nearest neighbor, okay? And I will create, let's say neighbors is 5. If you don't know about KNN, I have a separate video on my YouTube channel. So just in YouTube search code basics, KNN classifier, you'll get an idea. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just to save time, just straight away train it, okay? Train and print classification model. I'm using my most powerful tool, copy paste. Oh my goodness, this is unbelievable. Look at the precision recall, almost perfect, 99%. This can't get better than this, because especially with KNN classifier, I don't know if you noticed, but in the previous videos, when we were using TF-IDF and bag of n-grams, etc., KNN would perform horribly because it has an issue with higher dimension. And with TF-IDF bag of words, our dimensions are huge. Here, it's just 300 dimension vector. Okay, so that could be a conclusion that KNN really works well with a dense representation of your text. All right, so that's all I had. Just to summarize, we use Spacy's word embedding, train KNN and multinomial naive Bayes models. KNN perform really well, but multinomial was also pretty good. More than 94% is pretty good precision recall and even F1 score. I'm gonna be posting the exercises later. So whenever you check my videos, make sure in the video description, you look for the exercises. Sometimes I post a video and then post exercise after a few days. All right. And if you feel like contributing back, please give me a pull request. I hope you are having fun learning NLP. If you like this playlist, by the way, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends. And LinkedIn is an amazing platform. So you can write a post on LinkedIn talking about this particular playlist if you find it useful. If you don't find it useful, don't bother. All right. Thank you.